Welcome to Conversations Live. For more than a decade, we've brought you the best in books, entertainment, and current events. When the movers and shakers of the world have something to say to you, they say it to us first. And now, celebrating 15 years of broadcasting, here's your host, Cyrus Webb.
And welcome back, everyone, to Conversations Live. I'm your host, Cyrus Webb. Glad you all could join us once again. Whether you're tuning in here on the radio dial in Mississippi at WYAD 94.1 FM, we welcome you all back to our program. Also, those tuning in to our online affiliates around the world, including our Heart Radio family, we're glad to have all of you with us as well. We know today is being recognized as National Teacher Appreciation Day. I have a soft spot in my heart for teachers because they definitely have been there for me over the years, helping to encourage me to do the things that I love. So many others have been benefiting from teachers around the country. And today we're excited to welcome Ms. Becky Pringle to the program. She's the Vice President of the National Education Association. We're going to talk to Ms. Pringle not only about her own love of teaching, but also what it's been like for her to be an advocate not only for educators, but also for students as well, especially in the challenging times we live in today where there's so much that's affecting the school system. We also will remind you guys about the importance of supporting the teachers in your area. Ms. Pringle, hello to you and welcome to the program.
Hi, Cyrus. Thanks so much for having me on.
Oh, the pleasure is definitely all mine. I really respect the work that you've been able to do, Ms. Pringle, not only in the classroom, but definitely, as I mentioned, as an advocate for fellow educators in particular. I mean, what has it been like for you as you've reflected not only on your own time in the classroom, but also, of course, about the challenges facing educators today, about the importance of showing appreciation like we're doing this week for educators?
Oh, Cyrus, I appreciate that question. As you were asking it, you know, I'm a science teacher, eighth grade science teacher, and it took me back to being in my classroom and seeing the excitement around the adventure that's embedded in science for me anyway, and for my students, seeing their eyes light up when, you know, when they were in the dark and they pulled those Band-Aids apart and they saw that spark of light showing electrons being excited. It was so thrilling to see their curiosity stoked with the wonders of science. You're absolutely right that teachers help you do the things that you love. And too often we don't remember that, and that's why we set aside this day and, quite honestly, the week. We're celebrating all week long because one day is not enough. And asking everyone to think back and to thank a teacher. Everyone has had one that has made that difference in their lives.
That is so true. You know, Ms. Pringle, this always brings up to me, I graduated high school in 1994, and I had an art teacher who I'm still in connection with now, thanks to Facebook, who told me in 1994, when I was 17, that I was greatness in the works. Now, at the time, I didn't even believe that about myself, but she was able to see something, and she wrote that on a picture that she had signed for me, and I never forgot that. I mean, what has it been like for you to kind of reflect on also those who encouraged you to be your own personal greatness?
I know. Wow, that's fabulous. And it's one of the reasons why I went into teaching. You know, I did know I wanted to be a teacher from the time I forced my two sisters to play school on the front steps of our row house in North Philly until I actually went into the profession. Because absolutely the opportunity to bring out the brilliance in every student, because they all have that, to find that, to tap into that, there's just nothing better than that. And it's one of the things that we don't want to lose, quite honestly, as we lift up the challenges of teaching. We don't want to lose the excitement of teaching because we need more teachers. We especially need more teachers of color. We need to not only bring them into the profession, but we need to keep them in the profession because our students need them. And so we do need to lift up what is exciting and thrilling and inspirational about being that person that sees the greatness in the works.
Right, for sure. you know, Ms. Pringle, we have to talk about the challenges that teachers face today, so different than 24 years ago when I graduated from high school here in Mississippi. We didn't have social media, so cyberbullying was not a thing then. We didn't hear about all of the gun violence and the issues that were going on there. I mean, what is it that has made you not only want to be a tireless advocate for students, but also to stand up for educators and to talk about the concerns that educators have in the changing environment that we see today?
Yeah, and it was about that time when you were graduating from high school that I actually realized that that being a teacher for me, and for all teachers, to be honest with you, meant that I had to concern myself with not only the students that were in the confines of my own classroom, but I needed to worry about what was happening in those classrooms beside me, down the hall, and across the country, because I had the opportunity to find my voice and to use it to connect it with other voices so that we could collectively act on behalf of all of our students and our schools, and quite honestly, this country. Cyrus, the work we do impacts what this country will be. And so, right. And that's not an overstatement. And so it's so important for us to be advocates. But what we've seen over the last couple of months is that teachers and other educators all over the country are realizing they don't have to be in a position to be an advocate. They can advocate from where they are. And they're coming together in powerful numbers. And they are lifting up their voices. And they're saying enough. You know, they've been standing in the gaps for our students. You've heard this so many times. Right. They've been standing in those resource gaps forever. They've been buying those materials and making do with less. And they realize that it's too long and it's too much. And that this country needs to make that investment in its own future by making sure that every single one of our students, regardless of their zip code, has the school they deserve.
That's so true. And it's something that all of us should want, knowing that it's going to make our community stronger and this nation stronger. If you're just tuning in, you're listening to Conversations Live, we're excited to welcome to our program today Ms. Becky Pringle. She's the Vice President of the National Education Association. We'll talk with her as we're celebrating National Teacher Appreciation Day today, but also all this week. And really, it should be every day because of the work that educators have to do, talking about her own journey and also what it's been like for her today as an advocate. So, Ms. Pringle, what is your hope for us as we're kind of reflecting on this week, what do you hope that those, whether they have children or not in the classrooms, what do you hope they realize about the importance of supporting educators like yourself and making sure that you all have what you need?
Well, what we want everyone to realize is that they have a role to play. From wherever they are, they can make a difference. Today and this week, we're asking everyone to join us in our conversation on Twitter at #ThankAteacher. We want you to thank a teacher. That makes such a difference. But we're asking you to do more than that. And so that's why tomorrow, May 9th, we've set aside our #RedForEd campaign. And we're asking everyone to wear red because we can't just stop with thanking a teacher. We have to actually join them side by side and demand what we know our students deserve and what they need and what this country needs. And so that's going to look like, you know, if policymakers are not investing in our schools, then November's coming. We need them to go out and vote for people who will support public education and support our students and support our teachers. We need to not only take to the streets, but we need to take to the polls, and we need to keep that pressure up so that we don't have kids coming into our school that haven't had a day in their schools where they didn't suffer under the inequities and the lack of funding. We want every single student to be able to learn in an inviting environment where they're excited and they have technology and they have art classes. My goodness, Cyrus, can you imagine? We have students now that don't have what you had. They don't have an art teacher. They don't have a music teacher.
Right.
They don't have those classes. Think about where you'd be if that didn't happen for you. We don't want that for our students.
So definitely make sure you're using the hashtag, again, hashtag Thank a Teacher, and also remember to be able to wear red, of course, on May the 9th. And make sure you all are visiting www.nea.org for more information about the work that the National Education Association is doing. Ms. Pringle, thank you so much again for the time today. Really appreciate it, and looking forward to having you back on the program again.
Thank you so much, Cyrus. You have a wonderful day, and don't forget to thank that teacher who said you were greatness in the works. She was right.
I will definitely do it. Thank you so much for that. I appreciate that. And we thank your audience for tuning in to another great segment of Conversations Live. And make sure you all, again, using that hashtag, Thank a Teacher, and make sure you all are going throughout this week and moving forward, remember about the importance of educators around you. If you all came in late and missed part of the conversation with Ms. Pringle, don't worry. Thanks to our online friends, you all can catch the replay right after we go off the air. The link is already available through our social media site. So head over to Facebook.com/CyrusWebb or go to Twitter.com/CyrusWebb. If you click on the link there, you can listen to the show completely for free and share with your friends from there as well. Until next time, I'm your host, Cyrus Webb, saying as always, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy your world. Make sure you take out time to enjoy some good music as well as a great book. Thank you all for choosing Conversations Live today. You all make it a great one.